Hello everyone, Sharky2107. Welcome to
Kale!
Meow. Whatever it's called. So, joining me this time are...
Well, you already heard Bobby. How about me?
Yes, CFalcon here.
And Game Guy.
That Game Guy person. Never heard of him.
I've never heard of me either.
I never heard of him too. But how we got him in here, I don't know.
I'm just here.
Yeah, I was just in a bat.
You left the back door open. We snuck in.
Yeah. Lock your back doors, otherwise game guys get in. We don't want that.
No, we don't. And there's still your coins.
Yeah.
By the way, usually involving
some sort of gambling game. By the way, you fell in a hole.
Again.
This is called Let's Watch Sharky do something that doesn't work.
Hey, if it didn't work the first time or the second time, third time's the charm!
And it didn't work, so let's go.
Nope, fell in again.
Oh, good! We got the compass. Now we know where everything
is. Third room of the dungeon.
Oh yeah, it's a new feature. It tells you where the key is. If there is one.
I didn't know that.
That's one thing
Thanks
I don't
for telling me, game.
That's one thing in it, like, it keeps telling you, like, what, how many times?
In a way, the tone's a little helpful, but it's kind of obvious to tell which rooms have keys in them.
The tone is really helpful. Like, I think this is the first game where the compass is actually useful. Because in previous games, all it did was tell you where the boss is, and that's not hard to figure out.
Yeah.
At least in later games, when there's no tone, it tells you where all the chests are.
Let's see, the first Zelda game had a... It just told you the bosses. There was no compass in Zelda 2, to my knowledge.
I don't think so.
Or map.
No map either. Oh.
Game Guy likes his phone.
Game Guy's phone's going off.
Game Guy and his phone.
Use the power, Sharky!
Yeah, let's see. Is this just me, or when you get the power, do you run a little faster?
Yes, you do. Also, fun!
And a spell, I'm also like, okay, I learned something wrong.
Shark, you're supposed to make those into a square formation, not a line.
Yeah, Link is obsessive-compulsive like that.
I know, but let's break these things again.
Also, apparently this is... I didn't know Link helped make Tetris pieces, by the way.
Yes, he did.
There's the box. He made the line earlier. All he needs to make is the squiggly.
Okay, what's in here?
Hey, look! It's a dead end!
Okay.
By the way, Sharky?
Yeah.
Oh boy, anyone who's played this game knows Game Guy just said a very bad pun.
Yes, I did. Well, I figured the skull, you know, you don't really have to play the game before.
Playing it blind's not the best thing to do.
Yeah, Sharky, you'll probably be fighting some kind of Skull Knight or a giant skull foes in here later, I suppose.
Or something.
Or some sort of giant skull. Maybe it's a bubble.
Oh god.
Oh dear, not the bubbles! Not the bubbles!
That's what I really hate it. You know, bubbles are one of the enemies that, I kinda like the fact they made him, you'd be able to kill him, but there's one of the enemies that, the way it hurts you has not changed at all, really, in Zelda games.
Yeah.
Just tries to run into you?
Pretty much every game it curses you.
Actually, you're supposed to go that way first to get the key, so...
Yeah.
But really, going that way wasn't a loss.
No, but you gotta go back there later.
Yep.
Maybe. Way to spoil the game, Bobby.
It almost looks like a boss room, actually, in a way.
That's what I'm thinking now at the time when I'm doing this. Like,
But then again, I'm assuming there's a boss key for you to collect somewhere in this dungeon, so...
Yeah.
Nightmares somewhere around it.
It's that big key that's used to unlock the boss door that is sometimes called a nightmare key. I don't know why its name changes every game, but it does.
Nightmare key, boss key, big key, doesn't really matter, we all know what it is, right?
It's the same.
Yeah, I know.
Run away from Sparky.
Nobody likes Sparky.
Not even Sparky himself.
By the way, is that technically a Sparky or a Hothead?
I could not tell you what its official name is.
Because in Mario, well, I know making a crossover from Zelda to Mario, because it does in this game. In Mario, the bigger ones are called Hotheads, and the smaller ones are called Sparky.
You know, I could not tell you.
So...
yeah. I don't know offhand which one of them, too. I know that.
By the way, Sharky...
also, what up with the flying spear?
I don't know. It's telling me, do I need a bow?
Sharky arrows.
They look like spears. Tell me they don't.
And by the way, Sharky, that doesn't work.
No, I'm trying. Just watch slimes fall in holes.
You well, can make it for that, it's just really tricky.
Okay,
but... though, as I recall, you wouldn't be able to do anything over there anyway.
We need a very special item.
Yes, we do.
Very special.
I wonder what it could be.
Let's break the
shovel. Shovel.
Nope.
Yeah, what about Link's fish hook, though? He has a fish hook, why can't he use that?
Yeah, the thing over there looks like it has a hook on it. I mean, you tie a string to the end of the fish hook, and then you can, like, cool. Probably grapple it over here or something.
Why not? I mean...
what effect?
Why?
I mean, like it was mentioned some other time, you can kill Ganondorf with the fishing rod and Twilight Princess. I mean, yeah, that game was like 10 or 12 years later after this, but still.
I don't know, Ganondorf must have been an avid fisher or something. Like, seriously, he'd come home every day from fishing, and he'd be all like, oh, I caught a fish this big!
That's...
it wasn't really that big, it was that much smaller.
That's what they ate. Apparently, that's what his cronies have for dinner. He feeds them whatever giant fish he catches today.
The skeleton of a bomb. Skeleton?
Oh, no.
Yeah, and you know why You know why he tells you that clue by any chance?
Because you're... because you're dumb and not... that was new.
Ow! Oh, no. That you bomb was very nicely. He's slashing you with his sword.
Yes, he is. And maybe use the potion.
What? Huh?
Look, two skeletons far away.
Did he stop time?
Yay! The skull stopped time, and by the way, Sharky.
Yeah.
By the way, I think I know where you stopped it anyway, because I saw your mouth at the top of the screen.
Mouse? What are you talking about? I saw nothing.
Really, you did.
Alright,
he gives up.
I'll remember this.
Hey, he gave up, except,
ooh, it's chest.
Where did you go?
Slimes.
Sharky, open the chest. There's gotta be something good in it, right?
You got a nothing!
Basically, I've got one inside the box. Come and get it, if you can. Master of Skull.
That Skull's a jerk!
Yes, he is.
So he went into the next room, took the item, and ran off. So how can we get it?
He took off the item of the dungeon.
Maybe he is the item of the dungeon.
Oh, what a real object. This must be a way to tackle. How can Link tackle?
That's funny.
Okay, Link, seriously, do you know what you're talking about?
I seriously never noticed that text before, I don't think.
I think
or if I did, I just forgot.
You know what, no wonder Link doesn't say much in these games.
Yeah, because he cracks puns all the time.
Oh, my last bomb. Whoops.
That was a good use of a bomb.
And how can bombs explode in the water?
I don't know. Hey, I just heard that noise. It means you tried to use another one. You don't have any more. Your bomb license has been revoked. That's what that sound means.
I wonder why.
Because he
can't Let's take a look at Link's instant replay from Twilight Princess when he was a wolf inside that bomb shack.
Yeah, that went well.
Oh, look, it blew up.
Whoops.
But at least he killed the spider thingies.
Yeah, but even Midna is like, what the hell are you thinking?
Well, technically, he didn't really do it on purpose, but... I don't know.
Okay, if you light a fireplace on fire in a room with a bunch of flammable objects, what do you think's gonna happen?
You know, that does call the question. Why was there a fireplace in there in the first place?
Who knows?
Okay.
Starkey, I'm sorry. Back to what you're doing.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, this isn't Twilight Princess. Stop talking about it.
I love making references to other Zelda games in Zelda games, though.
Yes, because Zelda games are Zelda games.
I mean, I know they're each their own separate game, and the broken, screwed-up timeline completely proves that. But it's still nice to compare them, because they do have things that are actually consistent.
Looks like Link found out how to tackle this problem.
Oh, I did not get hit there, I don't know.
Yeah, by dashing into it.
Dashing is kind of a form of tackling, I guess.
I don't know about that.
Quirky guys. I hate these guys. Get away, get away.
I hate rooms like this. They do this in, like, every Zelda game. You've got to push a block, leave the area, come back, and it resets the block, and then you can go a different path.
Yeah.
They do that in, like, every top-down Zelda game. At least once.
You know, not to make another thing in Twilight Princess, but they kind of did that in Twilight Princess, too, in the Forest Temple.
Actually, they did it in Majora's Mask.
Slimes.
Are you talking about that one room in Snowhead where you have to keep, like, rolling?
No, the, what's it called,
Great Bay?
Oh, no.
Windfall? No, that's not the right name.
Woodfall?
Woodfall, that one.
Oh, that block in that one room.
Yeah. It's not exactly the same, so don't leave the room, but still.
Yeah, but you still have to push it and kind of...
At last! You got a piece of paper with dots on it.
Yep, and... And then our skull room with a 3. We already seen a 4. We defeated a 1.
Yeah, so maybe you need to find the 2.
It's another dead end.
Yeah, am I going to be dumb enough? No, I'm not.
Sharky, you must find the 2.
Where's your adventurous spirit?
Let's see.
Jump the shark.
What are you doing? Why did you go that way?
I didn't mean to fuck.
He felt like falling into that hole in the exact same spot twice, and possibly a third time.
That
just seemed like the thing to do.
Jump, yes.
Huzzah!
50 rubies. Nice.
Very nice.
Peter, don't even try that.
You want me to do this?
Something tells me no. Stop trying to run from, like, that's not gonna do anything.
Yeah, I'm not trying that again. But I'll do that.
That was the best jump ever.
I most hated it.
But, guess what, now you have to make it back across. Now go down there. And by the way,
again, I've never liked that gimmick. I mentioned this before.
Okay.
The whole dash boots and jumping thing. It's annoying.
Right, but that's in a lot of top-down Zelda games, too.
Oh.
Well, it's just... I don't like taking my sword off. I don't know why.
Sharky, where are you going?
I'm thinking, oh yeah, let's get back here.
Maybe something's changed.
Why didn't you bomb... You know, if they give you bombs in that little area, why didn't you try to figure out if there's some area you could bomb there? It looked like you could.
Maybe.
Yeah, let's go down. I know there's a crack in the hall.
Find out. By going the other direction.
Of course,
because of this stupid puzzle here, you could always, not get hit by Sparky, so you can try going there. And there's the one with the 2.
Yeah.
Oh, boy!
That's where he was. Oh, you found me. You're a real pesky kid. And he was a fight.
Wasn't that hard to find you, dude?
Out.
You were, like, totally just a few rooms away. You know?
Sparky, bomb!
You're not very good at hide and seek.
And I'm dead. I know it.
Right? Die?
Ooh, I hit him. Bum 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 bum!
Oh no! You got him!
Oh!
He got you.
And he wins.
Nope. Again, I think you do.
I don't know if I did try it or...
Not in, like, more recent games, I know, but, like... I think in Link's Link to the Past, whichever game it is, Link to the Past. I don't think I think you had to do it in there. You had to knock them down and then bomb them.
Actually, if I remember correctly, in Link to the Past, you had to... If you're gonna do what I was talking about, you had to drop 2 bombs on them.
Well, yeah, because I think the first bomb only just knocked them down or something.
Okay, let's see, what's this way?
You never went this way.
Cheapos!
You don't really need that to cross that gap, and I'm not sure how you didn't get hit there, but let's go with that.
Oh, look, I jumped on one.
I didn't know you could jump on those guys.
You can in Mario games, so why not here? And by the way, the torch... Oh, the torch is trying to kill you.
Oh, no!
Magical torch fireball thing.
Oh, did I ever mention that's another gimmick that got on my nerves in almost every top-down Zelda game?
Back under the torchlight beams do cross. Huh?
Torchlight beams do cross.
Oh, they're saved.
There's the boss door. And here's another dead end. Okay, or is it? I lied. Sorry.
Oh, look, there's a Goomba.
Squish it!
Hey! Ooh, I need heart. How do I get up here?
I don't know.
Sharky.
Yeah.
What does KN fire under the torchlight beams do cross?
Yeah.
What could it mean?
I don't know, but if I see something, I'll let you know what I think it means.
Let's see, ooh.
Where are you?
No. Am I trapped here?
You didn't even try pushing the blocks.
I know. I'm coming back here, let's see.
I have a feeling you could have pushed those blocks, but okay.
Yep,
I'm trapped. Let's get back out. Let's see, did that Goomba come back so I could get out of heart?
Nope.
Shark, you're not getting out of this area.
I want to kill Goombas.
I never understood why they stopped the music when you went into these little rooms. That was always annoying, because I hated the underground music. It was bland and boring.
Fire under the torchlight beams do cross. Remember that.
Remember it?
Oh, Guardian.
You've got a Guardian Acorn! You can throw it at a squirrel!
Look, one.
That'll show him.
In all honesty, this time when you're in here, actually try pushing the boss. See what happens.
Yeah, let's see.
His chances are one of those moves. Either that or the really mean, and you have to throw two pots.
Oh, good, I'm out. I've been here before.
Yes, you have.
Oh, good job, Sharky.
Oh, come on.
Now you're stuck here, and you gotta go back.
Nice.
Okay, I'm not going out.
Go for that room again. It worked so well the first time.
Yeah, go for that room because we didn't get enough entertainment watching you fail it the first time.
That was a short-lived acorn.
Oh no.
It will never blossom into a tree.
Yeah, Sharky, you might want to go back, where you were before. And not go
I think he's on the right way.
Yeah, I am. I was like, okay, where am I? Oh yeah.
No, I'm just letting him know, because, you know.
Stupid sword crystals.
Okay, we already beat this idiot. Let's get the slime.
Go down the stairs.
No.
Wait for the sparky. Oh, yeah, I need to hit that switch.
Yep, obnoxious puzzles are obnoxious.
Let's do this. Hit the switch. No. Okay, hit the switch now.
Button, push.
Oh, I hit these sparkies.
Okay. They are annoying. Hello, boss. How are you today?
Well, I'm trying to hit you. Do you mind?
Do you mind dying, please? I cordially invite you to your demise.
I'm trying to figure out a way to kick this butt here.
Sharky. Maybe try a spin attack. I don't know.
That might help.
Spin attack might cause him to drop faster.
Okay. I'm taking damage, but...
Unless,
I can't beat you. I'm out of here.
I took two bombs!
See, he runs away again. This guy sure is smart.
Let's go find that.
He's an idiot because the room with three is right next to this room.
Yeah, I frequently get lost in this dungeon for some reason. I can never remember where some of these rooms are.
He doesn't run that far, though.
Oh, no, there's something. You know, I'll take it.
Boy!
Maybe it helped me. You never know.
That's conveniently timed. Of course, if you keep dying by the smaller enemies, it's not really gonna help.
Okay, why is the room not opening? Oh yeah, let's go around, because I think there's a slime on the other side.
Yeah, there is. Ain't that obnoxious.
And I'm getting killed by Sparkies.
Well, so much for that.